Da har vi gått noen skritt høyere og endet opp hos Swazi. Og det ikke noen hvem som helst. Jeg sitter her sammen med Davy Hughes, som grunnleggeren av Swazi. Og jeg må si, første gangen jeg hørte om Swazi og Davy Hughes, det var gjennom podcasten Into the Wilderness med Pace Brothers. Og så ble jeg kjent med Lyngdal-gjengen. Og så bare ser jeg... Hva har jeg gått glipp av, tenker jeg. Så vi måtte bare komme innom Davy Hughes her på Swazi og ta en liten prat med han om hva han har å komme med for det norske markedet i 2018. So that was the Norwegian long intro, Davy. Are you still alive?
Doesn't tak.
Very nice to meet you. Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
I'm glad you had the time to squeeze us in this. You were actually sitting here a little bit resting alone, almost.
Almost. Yeah.
But the hospitality has been great. We got beers.
Wow, yeah, it's a little bit like Norway, you know. You want to have some fun. You want to, you know, a few beers doesn't hurt. And also, I think that, you know, hunters, they're friendly people, you know. So if you can give them to sit down, have a beer, have a talk, have a chat, that's much better than being really formal. Yeah. You'll notice
And you get to know the person.
Yeah, exactly.
Or a little bit of them.
For instance, I now know that your daughter is doing dog sledding in the northern part of Norway.
Yeah, she lives in Tromsø.
Yeah.
So and she's loving it, absolutely loving it. And
you know, she's sleeping under the northern lights these days, the Aurora Borealis.
Yeah, and she said it's so beautiful. She just lives in a lavu.
Yeah.
And yeah. So
on cold days like we have now in Norway, it's an abundance of northern lights. Yeah. So I think she's having a time of her life at the moment up there.
Yeah, and I think, you know, I've just been up there to see her. And so what was really great for me was to see, even though it was cold, and she's actually a dog sled guide, all of the gear she was wearing was Swazi. And she said, Dad, this shit works.
This shit works. But that's a cool thing, because Espen, he's been telling me that this shit works. Espen, when I'm talking about Espen, I mean Espen in Lyngdal, Jakt & Fiske Center, you know. But it does work, doesn't it?
It does, and it's actually part of my job as well. It's a hard job, and I try and look for someone to have it, you know, but I have to travel the world hunting and testing.
Oh, it's a hard work. Yeah. But, I mean, the payoff of Swazi, you say the most durable, what is it, the most durable outdoor clothing.
Yeah.
It's a bold statement.
It is, but I think also, you know, and we talked about this, was it's a responsibility, not just to your customer to produce something which is going to last a long time, but also to the environment.
Yep.
And so if we can make products that last 15, 20 years, then I think we're doing our bit for the environment. Make sure that A, the customer's happy, and B, using the world's resources as well as we can.
Yeah. And I think by the looks of it, you're doing a great job.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. And your daughter agrees. This shit works. Maybe you should shift the slogan to that.
No.
You know, this is beautiful. So for Swazi 2018, we're here at the EVA show. What do you have for your new line, or additional to the product family? What are you doing?
We've got two or three new products that we've bought here. And probably the first one is actually a garment which, along with Espen and Trond from Lyngdal, we've actually modified this Nahani, so it's got a windproof torso, but it's been modified for the Norwegian market.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's a particular pocket inside that's for the radios.
Yeah.
And then a tab for the aerial, and then somewhere for the earpiece.
Yeah.
So this is, you know, for years this was what I called a New Zealand standard garment, but now with these modifications, I really
Nordic,
hope...
Nordic one.
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool. So what would you say this garment here would be perfect for in the Scandinavian conditions?
Obviously, you know, if you're out in the snow, say hunting ptarmigan or reindeer, Then this is going to, yeah, absolutely spot on. Am I allowed to say seals? No.
You are. It's their seal hunting in Norway.
Yeah.
And even baby ones.
Probably seals as well. Should we move on to the
next? Yeah, next one. So what is this one? This is it's so light I almost lost it.
Yeah, it's and I love it. This garment here we've been testing for about 18 months, 2 years.
Yeah.
One of the garments which we love in New Zealand and the Nordic hunters have really taken to is our Tar XP. So I wanted to produce a garment that was long but was very, very light. So this whole garment has the length, you know, extra long length to cover your backside.
Yeah. Let's just hold it only up here. See there? Yeah.
Only weighs just over 340 grams, so it's very, very long.
And it goes down to your waist.
To just above your knee.
Right, right.
So it covers your ass.
It does. Yeah. Which yeah, but you have a lot of heat exposure from the back, especially if you have too short of a garment there.
Yeah, if you've got too short a garment, especially when you put a pack on
exactly.
or a day bag,
and they
it rides up.
Off.
Yeah, yeah, right. And then you know your kidneys, you've got to keep those warm. Yeah. So
that's a good point. All right, okay. Oh, and the last thing, we'll teleport over to that pale mute guy over there.
Okay.
He looks stout. What's he got here?
So this is our Kagul style, but it's a brand new fabric, and it's in the checkered style. So we're looking at bringing this out in about 2 months, 3 months time. It will be in the green, but also in a red and a blue. So I think that again, you know, it has a real traditional look to it, but it's a modern technical garment. It looks just like it's a shirt, but it's actually a rain jacket, 100% waterproof, windproof, breathable. And again, you've got the special pockets for the radios, the radio aerials.
Yep.
So again, it's got a real sort of a Nordic style to it. So I absolutely love this.
I'm looking forward to try it. Perfect. Anything else you have in store for the future? A secret you want to share, or are you nothing more to get out?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things I've always wanted to do was hunt moose in Norway. So
we have to make that happen.
I've got to make that happen. I've been wanting to do that for years.
Why is Espen not calling you?
I think we need to talk to him.
I think we need to
hunt. He's coming to New Zealand to hunt tar in 2 months' time. And maybe when he comes over, I'll be whispering. We'll be sharing the same tent. I'll be whispering in his ear.
Yeah.
Hey, moose hunting in Norway.
Hey, brilliant. Hey, thank you very much for your time, Davey. It's been a blast. Tusen, tusen hjertelig takk. Og hvis du ønsker å vite mer om Swazi og produktene deres, så ligger det en lenke her som tar deg inn til Lyngdal Jakt- og Fiskesenter sine nettsider, hvor du kan se mer om det. Det er de som er distributørene i Norge. Du kan også komme på Camp Villmark da en gang i april og ta og føle på en del av produktene der oppe. Og med det så løper vi videre her på IVA. Again, thank you very much, Davey. Og takk til deg der hjemme. Pregas!